Alright, so I figured it was about time I finally put something like this together. A lot of Let's Players that really try to connect with their audience will release things like this because it's a very transparent thing to do, and it gives you guys a little bit of information to go off of as well. I was thinking of just starting a series, not sure how often they'll be put out, but I'll just throw them out in like segments by subject. And I was thinking to do a series of tutorials on how I get my video from nothing to a video on YouTube for you guys to watch. I'll go through the various styles of videos that I go through, and I'll show you guys how I get from point A to point B, and sometimes with higher production videos, sometimes from point B to point C to get back to point B. Sounds like kind of weird, but a lot of it is just learning a bunch of little processes, and once you get all those little processes down, then it just becomes a series of routines that you get done on a day-to-day basis or a weekly basis, or a whenever the hell my next list video comes out basis. And you get a finished product, and you know, whether you like it or whether it's just okay, you find, you always find these little things that you want to improve on, be it in the actual process or just something artistically you want to convey differently in a future video. I'm not claiming to be an expert on any of this. This is very much a hobbyist thing that I do. You know, whether I was getting paid by Maker or not to do these videos doesn't really matter, because up until, you know, Christmas before last, I wasn't getting really paid for this at all, in the least, really. I still had, like, AdSense activated, but I mean, without a partnership, you don't really get that high pay rate on the ads, and, like, you get nothing. Like, I'm lucky to be actually getting checks from Maker every few months. And even then, it's just meeting the threshold, so, you know, this isn't me claiming to be an expert, or me trying to ride on any sort of monetary, gain, or even, like, with a lot of what YouTubers do, they try to make the money look like experience, which makes no sense at all. But I'm just showing you guys, some techniques that I just picked up on over these last almost 3 years now. I can't believe it's been 3 years almost I've been doing this. You know, I've been doing these virtually every day except for Sundays and the odd day or two that I might miss just because I'm not feeling it some days. So, you know, I've put out 800 videos. That's 800 times I've done this sort of process from starting with nothing and ending up with something. So, I'm not an expert, but I mean, I definitely have the fundamentals down. I have some idea of what I'm talking about. So I'm hoping to put you guys through step by step, from a hobbyist's point of view, not a professional's, to show you guys just some ideas on how you guys can do your own sort of videos like mine. Alright, so what's the first thing we're going to cover today? Well, I think a big part of what makes a creator on YouTube what they are is the environment that they work in. Now, this is whether it's going to be a hobbyist thing, or if you're doing this, again, as a professional for some monetary gain. Gotta put my slippers on. I mean, if you don't have a good workplace for doing your things, you're not gonna get a whole lot done, or it's not gonna get done to the best of your ability. It can be really said about anything, like if you're doing school or something, you know, if there's a project you gotta do. Usually, this is just me, I guess, but I find that if I have a special place dedicated to my work, or if I just do it in school instead of at home, I get a lot more done. Because there's distractions if you're doing it in a casual environment. And this isn't to say that my room is in any way a professional environment, but it has everything I need right here. This is my workplace. I have my TV, I have my consoles, I have my mouse, I have my laptop. This is the place. So we're gonna get the fundamentals down, of course, with a good workplace. This is gonna be a shorter video because a lot of it is very subjective, very abstract concepts. Because, you know, what makes a good workplace? Well, just, you know, whatever makes you feel comfortable. When I get to work on a video, I always throw open my windows, my blinds. I like the natural light streaming through, even on a cloudy day like today. If I'm not working on anything, I usually keep the blinds closed and just throw my lights on. I usually have two lights. This is how choosy I am. I only keep two of my light bulbs lit. This one's dead right now, and I like it that way, because I don't like a bunch of concentrated light over there, unless I'm working. I don't know why, it's just a tendency I kind of developed over the years. So when I'm working, I throw my light off, and I let the natural light stream through there. But when I go and sit down to work, of course, I have my lovely rolly chair right here. How nice is that? As you can see, it's a very cramped space as well. But when I go down to work, you're seeing exactly what I'm seeing right now. This is first-person view. This is my workplace. But I find that when I'm sitting down, my body sort of, you know, distracts from a lot of the natural light that should be pouring through right here. And, you know, even on a cloudy day, even on a sunny day, this room is still just a very sort of, you know, depressing dark gray. Before I painted it with the new wall color, and after, you know, it just sort of reflects that depressing grayish yellowish tone. So I have a very powerful bulb put into a little wall lamp right here, plugs right in behind my bed, and as you can see, it's a very powerful light. I throw her on, and I get a nice little orange tint against the wall here. It makes for a very comfortable workplace, I find. Now, another thing that I find very important is, this is going to sound friggin' nuts, but of course when I'm recording on a console, or even just off an emulator or something, I'll usually have my TV on alongside my laptop. You have the laptop on to get the capture, you have the TV on to actually, you know, stream the footage in real time. One thing I find super important is to really nail down where you like your laptop and where you like your TV. I find this is like a super important step, because if you, this is just me again, I'm very much a left-handed person, so I like to have my laptop to my left so I can get all the really technical stuff done with my dominant hand. That's just more agile, you know, stronger. It's just, it seems like a really tedious tiny thing, but I like it that way. I also like it this way because, of course, I use my mouse right-handed, like every other normal person. Some people use left-handed mice, but I don't. But I like having it, my TV over here, because my TV sits on an end table, which can set my mouse down on. So I have this space to use my mouse without actually needing a full desk. And it saves a lot of room, it saves a lot of money, and it's just more practical this way because it's also different elevations. So I can have my mouse nice and low so my arms don't get tired, and I can still look at my screen at head level. Again, this is just my interpretation of a good workplace, but really what I'm trying to bring home with this entire first video is that, oh, nice cat on the table, is that I cannot sit at the table and work because it's just not my place, man. It's just not where I should be doing my work. I don't feel right. I have to do it in my room under these conditions.